Yeah. Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Naram chaiva narottamam
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam
Tato Jaya Mudiraye
Nasta Prayeshu
Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhagavatir Bhavati Naishtaki.
Where is that Matiji?
This.
No, the one who translated before. What's the name? Kunamani. She's very experienced. We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 5, Text Number 43. Vishvasya
Vishvasya
Janma
Janma
Stiti
Stiti
Samyamarte
Samyamarte
Kritavatarasya
Kritavatarasya
Padambujam
Padambujam
Te
Te
Rajema
Rajema
Sarve
Sarve
Sharanam
Sharanam
Yat Isha
Yat Isha
Smritam
Smritam
Prayachati
Prayachati
Abhayam
Abhayam
Swapumsam
Swapumsam
Vishvasya Janma Stiti Samyamarte Kritavatarasya Padambujam Te
Kritavatarasya Padambujam Te
Brajema Sarve Sharanam Yad Isha
Brajema Sarve Yad Isha
Smritam Prayachati Advayam Swapumsam Vishvasya Janma Stiti Samyamarte
Vishvasya Janma Stiti Samyamarte
Kritavatarasya Padambujam Te Sarve Sharanam Yadisha Smritam Prayat Abhayam Swapumsam Vishvasya Janma Stiti Samyamarte Kritavatarasya Padambujam Te
Kritavasya Padambujam Te
Rajema Sarve Sharanam Yadisha
Rajema
Shat Jaman Stiti Smray Samyan Madri Krita Vartasya Patam Bhujante
Krita Vartasya
Jima sarva saranam yati yadisha
Rajama saranam yadisha
Smritam prayachitya bhajan svapungsam
Smritam prayachitya
Awarding.
Awarding.
Abayam.
Svapumsam.
Svapumsam.
Of the devotees.
Of the devotees.
奉献者的.
奉献者的.
Translation. O Lord, you assume incarnations for the creation, maintenance, and dissolution of the cosmic manifestation. And therefore, we all take shelter of your lotus feet, because they always award remembrance and courage to your devotees.
Even, 至尊主啊, 为宇宙展示的创造, 维系和毁灭, 您化身前来, 您的莲花族, 总是赐予您的奉献者们以记忆和勇气, 所以我们都寻求他们的保护。
Purport, for the creation, maintenance, and dissolution of the cosmic manifestation, there are three incarnations, Brahma, Vishnu, and Maheshwar, Lord Shiva. They are the controllers or masters of the three modes of material nature, which cause the phenomenal manifestation. Vishnu is the master of the mode of goodness, Brahma is the master of the mode of passion, and Maheshwar is the master of the mode of ignorance. There are different kinds of devotees according to the modes of nature. Persons in the mode of goodness worship Lord Vishnu. Those in the mode of passion worship Lord Brahma, and those in the mode of ignorance worship Lord Shiva. All three of these deities are incarnations of the Supreme Lord Krishna, because he is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. The demigods directly refer to the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord and not to the different incarnations. The incarnation of Vishnu in the material world is, however, directly worshipped by the demigods. It is learned from various scriptures that the demigods approach Lord Vishnu in the ocean of milk and submit their grievances whenever there is some difficulty in the administration of universal affairs. Although they are incarnations of the Lord, Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva worship Lord Vishnu, and thus they are also counted among the demigods and not as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Persons who worship Lord Vishnu are called demigods, and persons who do not do so are called asuras or demons. Vishnu always takes the part of the demigods, but Brahma and Shiva sometimes take the side of the demons. It is not that they become one in interest with them, but sometimes they do something in order to gain control over the demons.
要知，宇宙中有三位化身，分别掌管物质展示的创造、维系和毁灭。他们是 Brahma、 Vishnu 和 Maheshwar Shiva。他们三位分别负责掌管引起现象世界展示的三种物质自然属性。Vishnu 负责掌管善良属性 ，Brahma 负责掌管激情属性 ，Maheshwar Shiva 负责掌管愚昧属性。受不同自然属性的影响。 奉献者的种类也不同，受善良属性影响的人崇拜主 Vishnu， 受激情是属性影响的崇拜主Brahma，受愚昧属性影响的崇拜主Shiva。这三位化身都是至尊主Krishna的化身，因为主Krishna是存在中第一位至尊人格首神。在这世界中，半神人直接说自己脱不于至尊主的莲花族，而不是其他的化身。但事实上， 至尊主在物质世界里，Vishnu化身受到半神人的崇拜。我们从众多经典中看到，半神人在掌管宇宙过程中，一到一段困难，就去找躺在牛奶之阳的主Vishnu，陈述苦衷。主 Brahma 和主 Shiva 虽然是至尊主化身，但他们也崇拜主Vishnu，所以被算作半神人，而不是至尊性格神手。崇拜主 Vishnu 的人被称为半神人，反之称为恶魔。 Vishnu总站在半神人一边，但 Brahma 和主 Shiva 偶尔站在恶魔一边。这并不意味着 Brahma 和 Shiva 与恶魔有共同的利益，要与恶魔同流合污。他们之所以这么做，只是为了将恶魔置于自己的控制下。
Om Jnana Timurandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manu Visram Stapitam Yena Bhutale Svayam Rupakadamayam Dadati Swabharantikam VandeAnd they're describing how the Lord incarnates in the material world to perform the function of creation, maintenance, and destruction.
他们就描述说，至尊主在办在物质世界为了维创造、维系和毁灭的功能，化身为不同的，有不同的化身。
So the Lord.Appears in three different forms in this material world for this purpose.
为了这个目的，主在这个世界上就有各种化身。
He appears as Brahma for creation, as Vishnu for maintenance, and Shiva for annihilation.
为了创造的目的，他显现为主婆罗诃摩；为了维系的目的，显现为主 Vishnu； 为了毁灭的目的，就显现为主 Shiva。
Yesterday we went to temples. The first temple was the temple of Vishnu.
昨天我们去了庙，第一所庙宇是主 Vishnu 的庙宇。
The Angkor Wat.
吴哥窟。
And then we went to the temple of Lord Brahma.
接下来我们去了主婆罗诃摩的庙。
And the last temple we went to was the Shiva temple.
最后一所庙宇是主 Shiva 的庙宇。
And so we see how people in the Vedic culture, they were worshipping these three gods, Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva.
我们看到就是在伟达文明之下的人们，他们崇拜这三位神祇，主 Vishnu, 主婆罗诃摩和主 Shiva.
So Prabhupada explains how people in the mode of goodness, they will worship Lord Vishnu.
帕帕帕这里解释说，处在善良属性的人们会崇拜主 Vishnu。
Vishnu is in charge of the mode of goodness.
Vishnu 掌管着善良属性。
And people who worship Lord Vishnu, they're described to be like demigods or godly.
崇拜主 Vishnu 的人并被称为半神人，拥有半神人的品质、神性。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes that there is the divine nature and the demoniac nature.
博伽梵歌当中，主 Krishna 描述说有神圣品质和恶魔品质的人。
So the devi sampat means the qualities of the demigods, and this is for people in the mode of goodness.
处在善良属性的人们，他们拥有神性。
And then people who worship Brahma are more influenced by passion, and those who worship Shiva are more controlled by ignorance.
崇拜婆罗诃摩的人，他们受到激情属性控制，而崇拜主 Shiva 的人，他们处在愚昧属性的控制之下。
Brahma is busy with the creation. He was given the job to do the.Second part of the creation.
主婆罗诃摩忙于创造，他被赋予进行第二重创造的职责。
The initial phase of creation was performed by Vishnu himself.
第一重创造是由主 Vishnu 本人来负责。
And he is also responsible for the creation of Brahma.
而且他也负责创造婆罗诃摩本人。
Brahma is born from the lotus flower, which comes from the navel of Vishnu.
主婆罗诃摩诞生自主 Vishnu 莲花肚脐生长出的一朵莲花之上。
And Lord Shiva, he has the job to do destruction.
主 Shiva 的职责是毁灭。
But Shiva also helps in other things. He also helps in the creation and in the maintenance.
主 Shiva 他也协助创造，并且协助维系。
And we know that not everybody who worships Shiva is a demon.
我们知道并不是所有崇拜主 Shiva 的都是恶魔。
There are many devotees also who worship Lord Shiva and who go back to Godhead by the instructions of Lord Shiva.
有很多崇拜主 Shiva 的人，他们也藉着主 Shiva 的训示回归了神手。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, we can read about the Prachetas.And how they met Lord Shiva, and they were given the song chanted by Lord Shiva.
在圣典博伽瓦坛当中，那些 Prachita 们，他们得到了主 Shiva 的怜悯，在他的训斥之下，崇拜主 Vishnu 回归神手。
So Lord Shiva also gives mercy to people to make them devotees when they're qualified.
当人们有具有资格的时候，主 Shiva 也会赐予他们仁慈。
But if people want to be cheated, they want to get something material, they can get that from Lord Shiva also.
但是那些有物质动机的人，他们想上当受骗，他们也会得到主 Shiva 的仁慈。
So we said Lord Shiva helps a little bit in creation, because when Lord Vishnu glances over the material nature, that glance of Lord Vishnu is carried by Lord Shiva.
主 Shiva 他协助创造，就是当主 Vishnu 他瞥视物质自然的时候，这个瞥视是由主 Shiva 所携带的。
And Lord Shiva also helps in maintenance because sometimes Lord Shiva has to kill some demons.
主 Shiva 协助维系，是因为主 Shiva 他有的时候也会杀恶魔。
So Lord Shiva is a busy man. He's helping in many different things.
主 Shiva 是非常忙碌的，因为他协助了很多的功能。
But generally, we think of Lord Shiva as being responsible for the annihilation, the destruction at the time of the annihilate at the end of the universe.
但是通常人们就认为主 Shiva 是在宇宙毁灭的时候，他负责毁灭宇宙。
And the work of destruction is associated with the mode of ignorance.
而毁灭是跟愚昧属性密切相关的。
And to maintain something is much more difficult than to destroy it.
维系要比毁灭要困难得多。
Creation is not very difficult. It can be done. It's more difficult than destruction, but it's not very difficult. The most difficult thing is to maintain.
创造并不是很困难，虽然创造比毁灭要困难，但是，维系要比创造困难得多。
Just like opening a temple, when we open a center, you can open a center without too much effort.
正如比如说我们要开设一所中心、一所庙宇的时候，它并不需要很多的努力。
But to maintain it is very difficult.
维系庙宇要困难得多。
It takes a lot of determination and patience.
它需要人们付出巨大的决心和耐心。
And enthusiasm.
还有热情。
Right, so many places we open centers and then they would close.
我们在世界各地开设了中心，后来都纷纷关闭了。
We saw.Yesterday, so many temples, they were built, wonderful temples, but in course of time, they were forgotten about.
我们昨天看到有很多的庙宇都美轮美奂，但是随着时间的流逝，他们都纷纷关闭了。
The kings built the big temples.
那些伟大的君王，他们开设了巨大的宏伟的庙宇。
But after the king died, and then.Maybe his children or his descendants or the new king, they didn't care so much about the temple.
但随着这位君王他逝世之后，他的子孙后代或者是他的继承者们，他们就对这些庙宇漠不关心。
They thought, well, that's his temple. We don't care about that. I will build a temple for myself.
他们就要想，哎，这是那位君王他自己的庙宇，我不管他怎么样，我会开我自己的庙。
I will make a better temple in my name to make my name more glorious.
我要以我自己的名义开一所更宏大的庙宇，让我的名字名垂青史。
So in course of time, you see, we see that Angkor Wat. 1,000 years ago, there were many people living there. There was a lot of activity at those temples.
我们看到昨天在吴哥窟，当时的帝王。他开设了巨大的庙宇，当时很多的人们，上千的人们在那里做崇拜。
But now we go there, it's just like a jungle, just forest everywhere, trees everywhere.
但是昨天我们看到的，现在这些庙宇，他们都在就像丛林本身一样，都被丛林掩盖住了。
What happened? Oh, well, the effect of time came. Time came, and people died, and there was destruction and everything changes.
这就是因为时间的影响，随着时间的推移，人们都死去了，然后一切都改朝换代，都变化了。
Just like we look at China, great cities, big cities with many people.
我们看到中国有很多大城市，有很多人。
But in another 1,000 years, what will the place be like?Would be very different.
过一千年之后，这些大城市会怎么样呢？可能就完全面目全非。
1,000 years ago, what was Hong Kong like?
在一千年之前，香港是什么样子的
？Yeah, could we imagine what Hong Kong must have been like 1,000 years ago? Hurry, not many people, no big buildings, just some fishermen.
在一千年之前，香港那个地方就是一个渔村而已，住的都是一些渔民。
Things, everything changes in the course of time.
随着时间的推移，一切都改变了。
So these things are all controlled by different personalities, and there is a hierarchy in the material world. There are demigods controlling the material nature.
所以这些都是由不同的半神人，他们在物质世界掌管着不同的职责，他们是有一个体制的，自上而下。
And those demigods, they know, they're offering their prayers here, we're reading their prayer. They know that the nature of the material world, that there are three phases, creation, maintenance, and destruction.
这些半神人，他们对这个物质世界的本质非常了解。他们了解到物质，他们知道物质世界它有 创造、维系和毁灭。
Just like material bodies, our material body and all living entities with material bodies, they go through these phases.
我们的物质躯体，所有的生物，它们有物质躯体的所有生物，它们都要经历这三个阶段。
Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada describes 6 different phases.
圣帕巴在《国家梵歌》描述说，物质躯体经历六个阶段。
Right, you take birth, you begin to grow, and then you maintain, you produce some byproducts, then you dwindle, and then dead.
出生、成长、维持、产生副产品、衰落。
Right? You've all read this in the Bhagavad Gita. You know this. So the material world is like that also.
国家梵歌描述说物质躯体经历这六个阶段，这个整个物质宇宙也是如此。
So the demigods are not worshipping Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. They're only worshipping the Supreme Lord.
因此，半神人们他们并不崇拜主 Shiva 婆罗诃摩，他们崇拜至尊主。
They're just asking shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord.
他们寻求主莲花族的庇护。
Because they know there's one supreme Lord over everyone.
他们知道在所有生物之上有一个至尊主存在。
Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva are, we respect them.But we don't worship them like the Supreme Lord.
我们尊敬主婆罗诃摩，尊敬主 Shiva， 但并不把他们当作至尊主本人一样来崇拜。
If we don't respect them, then this is an offense. This is not proper behavior.
如果不尊重这两位神职，也是一个冒犯，也是行为不当。
One time, the gopis were looking for Lord Krishna.And they met Lord Narayan. Krishna disguised himself in the form of Lord Narayan.
有一次，牧牛姑娘们她们在寻找主 Krishna. 这时候 ，Krishna 他就把自己装扮成主 Narayan 呢，在牧牛姑娘面前出现。
So what did the gopis do when they saw Lord Narayan? They came and they offered their obeisances.
当牧牛姑娘们看到主 Narayan 呢在面前，她们就过来顶礼。
But then they asked him.Did you see Lord Krishna?
但是他们问主 Narayan， 你看到主 Krishna 了吗？
Krishna was hiding from the gopis, and he disguised himself by taking this form of Narayan.
Krishna 他就把自己变化成主 Narayan 的形象，就把自己掩藏起来。
So this time, because we just had last week, we had the bathing of Lord Jagannath. Before the Rath Yatra, we do the Snan Yatra, the bath of Lord Jagannath. And then Lord Jagannath, he does not give darshan after taking bath.
上周呢，我们有 Snan Yatra， 我们给主 Jagannath 的沐浴。之后呢，主 Jagannath 他就在一段时间不被世人所见。
So he goes into seclusion until the Rath Yatra.
他就隐居起来，直到弹车节。
So at this time, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he could not go and see Lord Jagannath in the temple for 2 weeks, every year like this.
每一年有两周的时间，主 Chaitanya 他不能去庙宇看到主 Jagannath。
So at that time, Lord Chaitanya would go, he would leave Jagannath Puri and he would go to a place called Alana.
在这期间，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他就会离开 Jagannath Puri， 他去一个 Alana 的地方。
And there he would worship Lord Vishnu.
他在那里崇拜主 Vishnu.
Actually, but that form of Lord Vishnu is actually Krishna hiding from the gopis.
实际上，那个 Vishnu 的形象就是 Krishna 从牧牛姑娘们眼前躲避起来的形象。
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would stay there for 2 weeks until time of the Rath Yatra, and then he would come back to Jagannath Puri.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 会在阿拉那那个地方待两周的时间，然后在弹车节时候再回到 Jagannath Puri。
So here, Prabhupada makes the point, he said that sometimes the demons, they will give some, they sometimes take the side of the demons, that Brahma and Shiva sometimes take the side of the demons.
在要旨当中呢，帕帕说，主婆罗婆母和主Shiva有时候站在恶魔一边。
Just like Lord Shiva was fighting for Banasura against Lord Krishna.
有一次主Shiva他就跟Krishna作战，他为了Banasura魔，他与Krishna作战。
Banasura had a very beautiful daughter.
Banasura有一位美貌的女儿。
And one of Krishna's sons, was it his son or his grandson? One of his Krishna's family fell in love with Banasura's daughter.
那么Krishna他有一个儿子或者孙子，他就爱上了这Banasura魔的女儿。
And Banasura arrested him. And when Krishna heard that his family member had been arrested by Banasura, then Krishna came with his army to fight. Banasura was very powerful. He had 1,000 arms. Yeah, you can see on the altar there's a deity with 8 arms.
在神坛上我们有一个八臂手臂的神像。
Right? It's a local, one of the local deities. It's for how the local people worship Lord Vishnu.
这是当地的人们，他崇拜主，威士主就以这种形象崇拜。
But Banasura, he had 1,000 arms.
巴纳苏拉摩有1,000个手臂。
So he was playing the drum for Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva likes to dance. And when you like to dance, you must have somebody, a good drum player.
主Shiva特别喜欢跳舞，一个喜欢跳舞的人，他喜欢有人给他伴奏。
Just like when you go to Rath Yatra, or when you go in the Kirtan, if somebody is playing the drum very nice, then you feel very energetic, you want to dance.
就像我们在弹车节期间呢，如果有人打乐器打得非常美妙的时候，我们就有起舞的冲动。
So Banasura was playing the drum for Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva was very happy.
然后那苏柔摩他就喜欢为主Shiva跳舞的时候伴奏，令主Shiva非常喜悦。
Because he had 1,000 arms, so he could really beat the drum a lot. He could make a lot of sound doing the drum.
他那苏柔摩他有1,000只手臂，因此他敲鼓的时候，他是非常擅长敲鼓的，用1,000只手臂。
So Lord Shiva was so grateful to him. He said, "I must give you some benediction. Please ask a benediction."
主Shiva对他非常喜悦，就让他要求一个祝福。
So Banasura asked Lord Shiva. He said, "I want you to stay in my kingdom and protect me. And if anybody attacks me, you should be here to protect me."
巴纳苏拉说，我请求你留在我的王国，保护我的王国。如果有人进攻，就请你保护。
So it happened when Krishna came with his army to fight Banasura, Lord Shiva was also there. Lord Shiva had to fight against Lord Krishna.
当主Krishna带着军队来进攻巴纳苏拉摩的城市的时候，正好主Shiva在，所以主Shiva就要迎战。So
it's a great battle.
那接下来就有一场大战发生了。Lord
Shiva would make a weapon, the Shiva Dwara.
那么主Shiva他就投出了他自己的致命的武器。
Yeah, the Shiva Dwara.
The Shiva Dwara.
And it burns everything, makes everything very hot. So Lord Krishna released the Vishnu Dwara.
主Krishna他释放出了Vishnu Dwara.
Makes everything very cold.
他就让一切都变得很清凉。
And when everything is hot, Although it's very hard, just like here, everything, but still people, life goes on, people keep working. But when it gets very cold, then everything stops.
就像在这里, 当一切都很炎热的时候, 人们还照常工作, 但是当一切变得很清凉的时候, 那么一切活动都停止了。
Everything freezes, nothing can work anymore, it all becomes, all stops.
当气温变得很低的时候, 一切都冰冻起来了, 这时候没有任何一个活动能进行了。
So, in this way, Lord Krishna conquered Banasura's army. He conquered Lord Shiva. Lord Krishna defeated Lord Shiva.
主Krishna就以这样的, 他的这种武器就战败了主 Shiva。
Krishna's army defeated the army of Banasura. So Banasura, because he had 1,000 arms, he had become very proud. So Lord Krishna cut off his arms and he just left him with 2 arms. He didn't kill him.
他没有杀他,
because he was a devotee of Lord Shiva.
因为他是主Shiva的为他奉献者,
so Lord Krishna decided to let him remain with Lord Shiva, but Banasura stay with Lord Shiva.
主Krishna就决定让巴纳摩活下来跟主Shiva在一起,
but he took away the pride of Banasura.
他只是把巴纳苏拉摩的骄傲傲气给拿走。
So sometimes these situations happen like this, that the Lord Shiva will give some blessing to a demon. Just like Vrikasura also got a blessing from Lord Shiva.
Vrika.
There's Vrita Sura and Vrik.
Vrika
Sura wanted the benediction. Oh, Vrikasura was doing tapasya, he was doing great austerities to get the blessing of Lord Shiva. He would cut flesh off of his body and offer it in the fire to Lord Shiva.
他把自己身上的肉给割下来，然后就供奉到主Shiva的祭火当中。
This is typical of the mode of ignorance.
这是典型的愚昧属性的人们的做法。
But Lord Shiva was not coming. He was not giving any blessing to him.
但是主Shiva并没有显现，没有赐福他。
So he decided, I will offer my head to Lord Shiva.
他最后决定，我要把自己的头颅献给主Shiva。
So he took a bath in the river, and while his body was wet with water, he was ready to cut off his head. And he was just about to cut off his head when Lord Shiva appeared. Lord Shiva felt sorry for him. Lord Shiva said to him, what benediction is it you want? But Vrikasura said, I want whoever's head I touch, their head will fall off.
我想要你给我这个祝福，无论我把手放在谁的头颅上，他的头立刻就会掉地。
And so Lord Shiva had to give this blessing. It's a stupid blessing.
主Shiva不得不给他这个愚蠢的祝福。
And then Vrikasura wanted to touch Lord Shiva's head. And Lord Shiva had to run away, and Vrikasura was chasing him. And finally, Lord Vishnu appeared, and Lord Vishnu spoke to Vrikasura.
最后主Vishnu显现了，就开始对Vrikasura摩说话。
And he told Vrikasura, he said, don't believe Lord Shiva. He been doing funny things these days. I don't believe he gave you that
power. 然后主维什诺就对维克苏拉摩说，你不要相信主希瓦，他有时候会做一些非常滑稽的事情，我从来不把他们当真。
And then Lord Vishnu said, you try for yourself, put your hand on your head, you'll see.
然后主维什诺就说，你不信你可以试试，把手放在你自己头上看看怎么样。
And so he put his hand on his head and his head fell off.
这个恶魔就把手放在自己的头上，他的头就掉下来。
So Lord Shiva was saved by the mercy of Lord Vishnu.
这样的主 Shiva 就得到主维什诺的仁慈之后得救了。
And we see Brahma also, he had devotees like Haranyakashipu who wanted benedictions that he wouldn't die.
We see that the Lord of Hermo, his devotee, Haranyakashipu, he wants to get the Lord of Hermo's blessing, he never dies.
So, this is the nature of people who worship demigods. They try to get these material blessings.
这就是那些崇拜半神人们的人们，他们这个本性，他们想得到物质的祝福。
But the demigods here and the devotees like these demigods, they don't want these kind of blessings.
但是在这个世界当中，这些半神人们和他们的像半神人的一样的人们，他们不想要这种祝福。
They only want the shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna.
他们只想得到主 Krishna 莲花族的庇护。
Because they know there they will get courage to fight the material nature.
他们会获得与物质、自然作战的勇气。
And they give also remembrance by taking shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna. Then we're able to remember the Lord better.
通过托庇于主 Krishna 莲花族，他们也会获得记忆，能更好的记忆主 Krishna。
So that is the real benediction.
这才是真正的祝福。
Devotee wants that kind of blessing. That please bless me with the courage to fight Maya.
奉献者们想要这种祝福，请赐予我勇气 ，Maya。